subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 18th of October. Indian farmers hold nationwide protest to demand minister's dismissal over Lakhimpur Kheri violence. Baloch activists and family protest against Hoshab killings, death of two kids in Pakistan. And India's first ever unique alcohol museum showcases brewing history of Goa. And now for all the details. Farmers disrupted train movement across India on Monday as part of a protest demanding the arrest and dismissal of Junior Interior Minister Ajay Mishra Theni over Lakhimpur Kheri violence case, in which his son is the main accused. The case pertains to the deaths of 8 people, including 4 farmers, who were allegedly mowed down by vehicles owned by Mishra while they were protesting against the government's 3 farm laws earlier this month.
Indian farmers agitating against 3 new farm laws blocked railway tracks as part of a nationwide protest called by Sanyukt Kisan Morcha, an umbrella body of farmer unions, on Monday, demanding the arrest and removal of Junior Interior Minister Ajay Mishra Theni from his post over the Lakhimpur Kheri violence, in which his son Ashish Mishra is the main accused. The case pertains to the deaths of 8 people, including 4 farmers who were allegedly knocked down by vehicles owned by Mishra while they were protesting against the government's 3 farm laws on October 3. Angry farmers had also allegedly lynched 4 people in the vehicles. The minister's son, Ashish Mishra, was arrested in the case on October 9 and is currently in police custody.
कि जो लोग आज सत्ता में बैठे हैं ये वो लोग हैं जिन्होंने हमारे 5 भाइयों को 4 किसानों और 1 पत्रकारों को निर्मम तरीके से अपनी गाड़ियों के नीचे कुचल के मार दिया लखीमपुर खीरी के अंदर जो इस सरकार की किसान विरोधी मजदूर विरोधी नौजवान विरोधी नीतियां हैं उन तमाम नीतियों को देश की जनता के सामने हम लेके जाएंगे और उसके बाद देश की जनता फिर इनके खिलाफ निर्णय लेगी
The 6-hour rail blockade affected movement of 160 trains in the Northern Railway zone, mainly in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh states, authorities said. The 3 farm laws introduced in September last year aimed to liberalize the agriculture sector. However, farmers fear the changes will make them vulnerable to big retailers.
Migrant workers in India's Jammu and Kashmir were seen fleeing to their hometowns on Monday, fearing for their lives a day after 2 non-local labourers were killed by terrorists in Kulgam district. Around a dozen civilians, including workers and labourers from other states, have been killed in the Kashmir Valley in recent days.
Migrant workers were seen fleeing to their hometowns from India's Jammu and Kashmir on Monday, after the recent killings of over a dozen civilians, including workers and labourers from other states. They said that they are scared and insecure after 2 non-local labourers were killed in Gulgam district on Sunday. The targeted killings have compelled them to leave, they said.
Hum Rajasthan ke Rajasthan wapas ja rahe hain. Yahan halaat kharab ho rahi hai, aise ja rahe hain. Kharab ho rahi hai, ye Bihari logon ko maar rahe hain, aise hamari thoda dar ho gaya hame. बच्चे हमारे पास है हमें डर लग रहा है
Laborers from outside Jammu and Kashmir travel to the valley every year for work while most of them leave before the onset of winter majority of them stay throughout the year
घर जा रहे हैं राजस्थान बिहारी लोग आए जो उनको मार रहे हैं जो इसलिए बस डर लगता है घर जा रहे हैं
The wave of violence against civilians has triggered a widespread crackdown by security forces. At least 7 Indian Army soldiers have also been killed during counter-terrorism operations in the valley in the past 1 week. India accuses Pakistan of supporting militancy in Jammu and Kashmir. Islamabad denies the charge, saying it only provides diplomatic and moral backing to Kashmiri people.
As the standoff on the appointment of Pakistan's new spy agency chief drags on between Prime Minister Imran Khan's government and the powerful military, key opposition leader Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has slammed the former, saying Imran Khan is trying to turn army ISI into his Tiger Force. Tiger Force is a group of Khan's party activists who assist local authorities in emergency relief activities.
Key opposition leader and Pakistan People's Party PPP chairperson Bilawal Bhutto Zardari on Sunday slammed Prime Minister Imran Khan and said he is trying to turn all institutions of the country into his party Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf or PTI's Tiger Force. Khan is also trying to turn the army and spy agency ISI, Inter Services Intelligence, into his Tiger Force, he added. Addressing a rally in Karachi in commemoration of those killed in 2007 in the twin terror attacks in the city, Bilawal claimed that the countdown for the government's end has begun. He termed current state of affairs showed this is not change but destruction.
Ke Khan saab is mulk ka har idara ko apna tiger force banana cha raha hai. पहले हमला किया अपना पार्लियामान पे, हमारा नेशनल असेंबली पे, हमारा सेनेट पे, तो फिर हमला किया जुडिशरी पे.
Bilawal's comments come as the relationship between Pakistan's top civilian and military leadership has been under strain ever since PM Khan refused to notify the Karachi Corps commander, Lieutenant General Nadeem Ahmed Anjum, as the new chief of the spy agency. Pakistan's Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa had reshuffled the top military hierarchy on October 6, appointing Anjum as the new chief and incumbent ISI Director General Lieutenant General Faiz Hamid as the Peshawar Corps commander. Meanwhile, Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid has said that the issue of appointment of the new ISI chief would be resolved within a week, but was reluctant to give reasons for the delay. Reports suggest that many lawmakers of Khan's PTI are concerned about the developments. PTI enjoys a thin majority in the parliament, and that too with the support of lawmakers who are loyal to the country's powerful military establishment.
Moving on, protests have continued across Balochistan to demand an impartial inquiry into the recent death of two children allegedly killed in a mortar shell blast in Hoshab area by Pakistan's paramilitary frontier corps. Activists have long accused that Pakistani security forces have been carrying so-called military operations in the region with an aim to eliminate the Baloch people.
Protests have continued across Balochistan to demand an impartial inquiry into the death of two children allegedly killed in a mortar shell blast planted by Pakistan's paramilitary frontier corps in Hoshab area recently. A large number of Baloch activists, students and family members of the victims have been holding a sit-in protest in Quetta, demanding the immediate removal of the frontier corps from Balochistan and the arrest of personnel responsible for the killings. A family member blamed authorities also tried to bribe them. However, they will not end their protest until a case is registered against the frontier corps. In the latest on Monday, Balochistan's Home Minister Mir Ziaullah Langau announced that a committee under his chairmanship has been formed to probe the Hoshab incident. Activists have long accused that Pakistan Army has been carrying so-called military operations in the region for years with an aim to eliminate the Baloch people. They blame thousands have been internally displaced because of armed conflicts and army operations over the years.
Taliban authorities have pledged to step up security at Shiite mosques as hundreds of people gathered over the weekend to bury the victims of the Islamic State's suicide attack on worshippers. Afghanistan's Foreign Minister Amir Khan Muttaqi, in an interview with the Turkish news agency, said that Islamic State was not emboldened, but there is rhetoric in favor of the group.
Afghanistan Foreign Minister Amir Khan Muttaqi, in an interview with the Turkish news agency Anatolia on Sunday, said that Islamic State was not emboldened, but there is a rhetoric in favor of the group. Of course, there is rhetoric in favor of the group to show the current government of Afghanistan as weak. The pressure is building on the current government from abroad, and the Daesh is taking advantage of this pressure, Muttaqi said. Taliban authorities pledged to step up security at Shiite mosques as hundreds of people gathered on Saturday to bury the victims of the Islamic State suicide attack on worshippers. Islamic State, which is a hardline Sunni group, claimed responsibility for Friday's attack at a mosque in Kandahar. A group of suicide bombers shot their way into the largest Shiite mosque in the city before blowing themselves up during Friday prayers. According to the local health official, the death toll stood at over 40. The head of Kandahar police said units would be assigned to protect the Shiite mosques, which have so far been guarded by local volunteer forces with special permission to carry weapons. Attack on Shiite targets associated with the Hazara ethnic minority, who make up the biggest Shiite group in Afghanistan, were regular occurrences under the former Western-backed government. The attacks have continued since the Taliban seized power in August, tarnishing the movement's claim to bring peace to Afghanistan after decades of war. Since the takeover, Islamic State has conducted dozens of operations, from small-scale attacks on Taliban targets to large-scale attacks on civilians.
Bangladesh's Interior Minister Asaduzzaman Khan Kamal on Monday said that those involved in Pirganj incident were identified instantly and 45 people were arrested so far. Addressing reporters, Khan said that Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has directed all concerned to provide necessary assistance to the victims and rebuilding their houses will begin soon. Fresh communal violence was reported in Bangladesh on Sunday when more than 20 houses and shops of Hindus were burned down by a mob in Rangpur city. This incident of violence comes just a day after two Hindu men were killed amid the recent unrest in the country. Protests began last Wednesday after footage emerged on social media about the alleged desecration of the Holy Quran at a pandal, temporary structures housing idols during Durga Puja festivities in Komila city. At least four people were killed on Wednesday when police opened fire on a crowd of around 500 people attacking a Hindu temple. Over 80 locations were attacked in Komila city, leading to further unrest across Bangladesh. Many pandals and temples, including the ISKCON temple, were attacked. Violence also broke out in the capital Dhaka and Chittagong on Friday. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has vowed to bring to justice the culprits behind the violence, saying those involved in the attacks will not be spared. Adding another feather in its tourism industry, India's Western Goa state has opened the country's first ever alcohol museum. Set up by a local businessman, the museum is dedicated to the locally brewed alcohol Feni, which is one of Goa's most loved features among the tourists.
India's first museum dedicated to alcohol, located in the tiny beach of Kandolin in Western Goa state, has opened its doors to spirited enthusiasts. A local businessman, Nandan Kurcharkar, has set up this museum named All About Alcohol. Nandan, who is also a collector of antiques, said that the aim of opening this museum is to make the world aware of Goa's rich cultural heritage and about the origin of Feni, the strong local drink. It also aims to offer a fresh perspective on the art of drinking.
I don't know who invented alcohol, but India is the first country which has an alcohol museum. Feni is also used for cooking. Feni has various parts of Goan life.
The museum has hundreds of artifacts linked to Feni, including large traditional glass vats, in which the local cashew-based alcohol was stored centuries ago. It also displays a massive collection of antique wooden shot dispensers and antique wine glass bottles.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.